I was seeking for things that could not satisfy, and then I heard my Savior speaking, draw for my well that never shall run dry. Fill me, Lord, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up.
There are very few people who are lifting it up.
Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, fill me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. There are millions in this world who are craving the pleasure earthly things afford, but none can match the wondrous treasure that I find in Jesus Christ, my Lord. Fill me, Lord, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. So, my brother, if the things this world gave you, live on, gas that won't pass away. My blessed Lord, we come and save you. If you need to him and humbly pray, fill me, Lord, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bed of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole.
Ask the Lord tonight to fill you up with His Spirit, or whatever it is that you are asking and you need urgently, whatever your urgent needs may be, ask that the Lord will visit you in that area tonight and fill you up, and fill you up, and fill you up, you know, to overflowing, to overflowing. I don't care what you have already, you don't have enough. I can tell you that. You have the Spirit of God, you can get more. You know, you have the blessing of God, there is more that you can receive. You know, your barns are flowing with blessing, you can receive more blessing. If you don't need it, give it to somebody else. Ask God tonight, say, Father, visit me in a new and living way. Fill me up, fill me up, fill me up with the fullness of heaven, with the power of heaven, with the grace of heaven. Lord, I want you to fill me tonight. Fill me tonight. Oh Lord, visit me personally, visit me individually, visit us, oh Lord, as a family and as a congregation. congregation, Lord, visit us tonight. We don't have enough. We don't have enough. All that we need for life and godliness that you are giving unto us, O Lord, we have not received all of them. And so, Father, we come tonight that you will fill us up. Fill us up even to overflowing tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, let our hearts be available, O Lord, ready to receive the bread from you. Let our lives be open for you to pour your blessings and open the windows of heaven upon our lives tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. God will make room for you. God will enlarge you. You will be blessed in his presence tonight in the name of Jesus. Please be seated. Tonight we want to pray about enlargement. Everybody say enlargement.
Enlargement.
Room maker. Everybody say room maker. God is the one that makes room. And when God makes room, that means he enlarges. He enlarges your coasts. He increases you. He makes you more than you are. God, you know, magnifies his glory and his power upon you. That's what we want to pray about tonight. The God that enlarges. Actually, our passage is beginning from a very peculiar or very familiar one also. Chapter 26 of the book of Genesis. Very familiar. But there are some things we want to bring out there and then pray about them. Of course, you have to realize that the man we are talking about here is a man that was greatly blessed of the Lord. Isaac was a man that was greatly blessed of the Lord. He was the one who was supposed to be the heir of all the blessings that God has bestowed upon his father. His father, Abraham. And, you know, with all these blessings that are coming upon him, he is still looking for more. You will look for more. You will get more. In the name of Jesus. And in all the areas that you need the blessing of the Lord in your life, God will bring it to you in Jesus' name. Actually, at this time, there was a little bit of famine where Isaac was. And Isaac will not keep quiet. I pray you will not keep quiet. That whatever the Lord is blessing you with in the land where you are now, you will ask for more. I say you will ask for more. You know, many a times for us who are from Africa, after you get to America, you get all that you have can get. It will look like you've gotten everything you can. But let me tell you, there is more.
Amen.
Tell somebody there is more. There's a lot that God can give you. You know, if you get a little thing and then you are satisfied with that, well, if that's your satisfaction, God will say, that's okay. But he say, I wish you ask for more. And I pray you will ask for more tonight. Because as you ask, the Lord will give you. I said, as you ask, God will give you tonight. In the name of Jesus. And the blessing of the Lord upon you, the Lord will continue to enlarge it in Jesus' name. Here is a man, as I told you, greatly blessed. Back up to chapter 25. Chapter 25, it says in verse 19, and these are the generations of Isaac, Abraham's son. You see, when he was talking about Abraham's son, he didn't go to the other son. There was another son, but here we are talking about a man unto whom the fullness of God, unto Abraham, has been, God has beheld it and given it to him. He says, Abraham's son. And he says, Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac was 40 years old. From this point, God was talking only about Abraham and Isaac. Can you believe that? There are just two people God was reckoning with here. He says, Abraham, my friend. Abraham, the one, you know, who was always on my side. Abraham, a man who listened and obeyed me. And then, the heir to the throne. You know, we just finished a program that says, we are heirs of the kingdom. Amen. Now, here he's talking about an heir of the kingdom like you. I said like you. And tonight, the way the Lord blessed him, God will bless you the same way. So he was an heir of the kingdom. And we are told, but unfortunately, he was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife, the daughter of Bethuel, the Syrian of Padan Aram, the sister to Laban, the Syrian. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife. Why? Here was a man that he knew already. Of course, when you look at the life of Isaac, you will understand that he was a man of faith. Praise God. Even at a very young age, you know, he partnered with the father in faith. Think about it. At his age, the father wanted to offer him as a sacrifice, and he didn't resist. He trusted God so much that he was willing to offer himself. You know, it was like somebody foreshadowing the Lord Jesus Christ, saying, I'm willing to offer myself if that's what it takes. So he was a man that was consecrated. He was a sacrificial man. He was a man that was selfless, ready to give himself. You know, he said, Dad, if that's what God requires of you and you have made a commitment to the Lord, that's okay. You know, just go ahead and do whatever you have agreed with God. See, children, that's how we are supposed to be. We're supposed to be like Isaac, you know, who agreed with the father concerning what God has asked that family to do. No wonder till today, the blessings of Abraham, the blessings of Isaac, and that of his son Jacob remain forever. Your blessing will remain forever. Whatever God blesses you with, and I believe tonight, whatever he blesses you with, it will be something eternal. Something that endures. Something that is not temporary, but something that will enlarge you, not just here on earth, but in heaven also, in Jesus' name. And so this man took a wife, Rebecca, and they had no child. But because he was a man of faith, the only way he knew that this blessing was going to be given to him, verse 21, he entreated the Lord for his wife. He prayed, he pleaded with the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him. Praise God. The Lord was, you know, so he was a man who was in tune with God. Brethren, if you are going to be a man that is enlarged like this man, you have to be a man that is in tune with God. You have to be a woman that is in tune with God. You have to be constant. You know, your relationship with God must be fresh. It will not be stale. It will not be historical. Yeah, I used to be with God. I used to love God. I used to be in the house of God. I used to work for God. I used to be a worker. I used to do this. I used to, you know, for some people's relationship with God is used to. Used to. Those are useless things. Used to is useless to God. You know, what is good and what is profitable both to you and to God is current salvation, current relationship. I pray God will make your relationship current. I didn't hear you now. I say your relationship will be fresh every day in Jesus' name. Fresh power, fresh grace, fresh mercy, fresh anointing, fresh joy, fresh gift of the Spirit. You know, fresh day. Every day will be fresh and renewed for you in the name of Jesus. And so, you know, he entreated the Lord and the Lord was entreated. That means God heard him. Amen. God listened to him. God will hear you. I said, God will hear you. God will listen to you. Every time that you pray with God, God will answer you. You know, the Bible is always saying that we, as children of God, we must ask from God. He is our maker. We ask him. Isaiah chapter 45. Let me put my hand here. We're going to come back because we'll read chapter 26 later. But Isaiah 45. He is our maker. We need to ask him. He is the one who makes things happen. Amen. Who makes things happen for you?
God.
Who makes things happen for you?
God.
And who is going to make things happen for you tonight?
God.
It's only God, and he's going to do it.
Amen.
Isaiah 43, look at verse 11. I am the Lord, and beside me there is what?
No.
There is no Savior. Beside me, there is no Savior. There is no one who can do anything. In fact, it's not just Isaiah only who said it. Look at Jeremiah. The same way, Jeremiah 33, in verse 2. Thus says the Lord, the maker thereof, the Lord that formed it, to establish it. The Lord is his name. Praise God. He is a God that is a maker. He is the God that formed things. He formed things out of nothing. Amen. He brings something out of nothing. Oh, you may be saying, Pastor, I'm not even sure how this is going to come. Don't worry about that. God will bring it to him.
Amen.
You know, Mary said the same thing. How shall this be? What was the answer? The Holy Ghost. I said the Holy Ghost. Yes, in the day of Mary was the Holy Ghost. In our days, it is still the Holy Ghost who is the messenger. But in the days of all these people, God himself will have to do it. You have to pronounce it. He was the maker and he is still the maker. He says he is the maker thereof. He is the Lord that formed it. And after he formed it, he will do what? He will establish. Amen. It's not a God that abandons people halfway. God will not abandon you. In fact, you need to tell yourself, I know God cannot abandon me. That's how faithful my God is. He will not abandon me. He will be with me. He will lead me. He will guide me. He will protect me. He will provide for me. That's the confidence that we have in God. And I pray your confidence will remain in him in Jesus' name. He is the one that formed it. And he formed you, number one. He made you. He formed you so that he can do what? Establish you for his name's sake. Amen. He did it for himself. Not because of you and I. Not because we are better than anyone else. He did it. That's why he said in verse 3, call unto me and I will answer thee. As you call tonight, God will answer you. And then he says, as your maker, I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. There are things you already know. You know, we don't want to pray about things you know tonight. The things you already have. I want you to pray tonight for things you don't know. Things you don't have. Amen. Things you are expecting God for. You said, I know he's a maker. I know he's the one that forms. He is able to bring that thing to pass. I don't care how difficult it is, just ask him. I said, just ask him. Don't think about the difficulty of your situation, just ask God. Yours is to ask God, his is to answer. So don't help him with his own side, because he is not willing to help you with your own side. You do yours, he does this. So you make prayer to him, he answers. Is he going to answer you tonight? Will he answer you tonight? Yes. He is your maker. He is the one that formed you. He will establish you. Amen. I said he will establish you. Amen. So shall it be in Jesus' name. So back to Genesis now. The Lord answered him. He was entreated. And Rebecca, his wife. We are back to Genesis 25, verse 21. Rebecca, his wife, conceived. Amen? Amen. Rebecca, his wife, did what? Conceived. God answered. That's the blessing. That means the woman received the answer to the husband's entreaty. Everything you entreat the Lord tonight, you will hold it. You will behold it. You will handle it. You know, because Rebecca knew that the blessing had come. You will know the blessing has come. You will have a feeling. You will see it. It may be a blessing that takes some time to come, but from now you begin to have a feeling of it. In the name of Jesus. God will begin to show you a token that your prayers are answered. Amen. I said your prayers are answered. Amen. And when God answered them, they were just looking for, just give us a child. But what did God give them? Two nations. Amen. Amen. God didn't just give them, if they just give you, say it's just two children with God. No, God says two nations. Praise God. Praise God. That's the God that enlarges. The God that you ask for one thing and he makes it multitude. He enlarges. You don't know how he's going to do it. That's why you don't worry about that. Just ask him. Just trust him. Just have faith. And your faith will receive a just recompense tonight in Jesus' name. I say you will receive a just recompense tonight in Jesus' name. Now, I read that to you to show you that the man I'm talking about, the man Isaac, was blessed. So, the fact that there was a famine in chapter 26 does not mean that he was not blessed. But because he needed more blessing, so he said, let me remove from where I am. Let me go somewhere else. If I can get more blessing. Look at chapter 26 now and verse 1. And there was a famine in the land. Beside the first famine that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of Philistines, unto Gerar. And the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down into Egypt. Dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. Sojourn in this land, and I will be with thee. And I will bless thee. For unto thee and unto thy seed, I will give all these countries. Amen. God already told him, I'm giving you nations. Now, God is making it. God is elaborating it. You know, sometimes when God gives us blessing and he tells us something, we don't know the extent of it. God just said, two nations are in your womb. How do you understand that? Two nations. Two nations. Is it America and Europe? America and London? America and Canada? Two nations. Which one? What is? You know, you don't know. But God is saying, now I'm going to make it plain unto you. Amen. What you are going to receive tonight, God will make it plain. Amen. It shall be explained clearly unto you. Amen. The Lord says, there are some things you cannot do because of what I want to do in you. Amen. You see, this is what people don't understand. When God has marked you out for something special, there are certain things you cannot do. And people may say, but everybody else is doing it. But everybody else is not Isaac. Amen? Amen. Everybody else is not Akinyadeni. That's just me. I'm special. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Everybody else is not me. What God wants to do for me, I believe him. I know he will do it. It doesn't matter how much hindrance the devil puts in the way, it will be done. Because he is my maker. He's the one that formed me. He will establish me. My maker. He formed me. He will establish me. Amen. That's what that book of Jeremiah just tells us. So if he made us, he has a reason. If he formed us, he has a reason. For his glory. Not for shame. For his glory. Not for disgrace. For his glory. Not that people will wash mouth over him. For his glory. Not that people can blaspheme him. He will establish it. Irrespective of the obstacles and the opposition. And God will establish you. So he said, Isaac, you can't be like the people around you. Don't do like them. Don't go down to Egypt. Because when there's a little problem, everybody wants to go to Egypt. What does Egypt signify in our time? It means actually going back from where God wants you to be. You can call it backsliding. You can call it abandoning where you are and going somewhere else. You may even include that you are in a place like this and things don't seem to be the way you want. And then you say, maybe if I go to so and so or that church, maybe things will be better there. That's what people do. But God told Isaac here, you are not like that. You are not an ordinary person. Remain here, dwell here, sojourn in this land where I put you, and I will be with thee, and I will bless thee. Amen? Amen. And the word of God was sure unto him. In fact, I can say this is one of the first areas where you can see the I will of God. Amen? I will. Let me show it to you. As God gave him that instruction, in verse 3, he says, sojourn in this land. Look at number the first one. He says, I will be with thee. Number 2, I will bless thee. For unto thee and thy seed. And then number 3, he says, I will give all these countries. And number 4, and I will perform the oath which I swear unto Abraham thy father. Number 5, and I will make thy seed to multiply as the stars of heaven. Number 6, and I will give unto thy seed all these countries. In thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because that Abraham obeyed my voice and keep my charge and my commandments, my statutes and my law. Praise God. So God was very explicit. You know, it's like Bible says, you know, that God didn't have anything by which he can swear. He swore by himself. That's the same thing here. God says, I will do it. I will do it. And he said it 6 times for emphasis. God only need to say it twice, and you know, Bible says by 2 immutable things. But God says, the same thing that God said is like the same thing, 6 times. Amen. It borders down to the same thing. I will be with you. That's a blessing in itself. Hallelujah. Praise God. If God be for us, who can be against us? I will bless thee. God says, okay, I double it again. I will be with you. That's blessing. And I will do what? And I will bless you. So you are blessed already because I'm with you. But now I'm going to add blessing to it. Double blessing. Oh, you think 2 is enough? Then God says, and I will make. He said, and I will give. I will be with thee. I will bless you. And I will give. Okay, what else can God not give? Praise God. He that giveth his only begotten son unto us, how will he not freely give us everything, all things? I will give. And then he says, for you to know, that thing I said I will give, I will do what? I will perform. Praise God. The God of performance, he will perform for you. Amen. He will perform in your life. Amen. I will perform the oath which I swear unto Abraham. And then he says, and I will make. He says, I am even going beyond you now. I am extending it. The generations after you, this blessing is not stopping with you. It's going beyond you. Amen. The blessings of tonight will go beyond you. It will go into generations to come. He says, I will make thy seed to multiply. Amen. And I will give. God doubled it again. He says, for you, I will be with you. Number two, I will bless you. And I will give unto you. And I will perform. But listen, beyond you, I will make thy seed. I will give unto thy seed. Hallelujah. So it's like God is doubling and doubling and redoubling the blessing. Amen. Amen. I pray that will be your portion tonight. Amen. I said that will be your portion tonight. Amen. Now the question is, why did God really make room for him? Why did God mightily bless him like this? As you look at that passage, you know, I'm not going to have much time to read too much because I really want us to pray, but I still need to tell us. Number one, why did God make room for this man? Genesis 26 verse 2 and 6 has the answer. Genesis 26 verse 2. And the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down into Egypt, dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. Look at verse 6. And Isaac dwelt in Gerar. What does that mean? Obedience. That's number one. 1 Samuel 15:22 says, to obey is better than sacrifice. To obey is better. There's no, God counts obedience so highly. He says, you obeyed me, wonderful. The same thing, your father obeyed me, and you now, you are entering to the blessing of your father, and you are so obedient. I'll give you, you are going to get double. I say you will get double. Amen. I say you will get double. Amen. You know, some of us who are children here and your parents are Christians, begin to rejoice. Because you get double. Amen. I said you get double. I'll show it to you. You get double. Because the fact that your parents are Christians, the blessing of God that they have been accumulating, God transfers them also to you if, what did I say? If you remain in that same obedience, like Isaac. Praise God. Amen. And I pray all our children will be obedient. Amen. The blessing of God will be upon them. Amen. So number one, we see is obedience to God's command. Exodus 24 verse 7 says, and he took the book of the covenant and read in the audience of the people. And they said, all that the Lord has said, we will do and we will be obedient. Amen. That's what God is expecting. Exodus 24, verse 7. You can put it under that first point there. Number two, Genesis 26 and 3. Genesis 26, look at verse number 3. I read it to you, those six things. Sojourn in this land, I will, I will, I will, I will. What does that mean? Following God's will for him. So number one is obedience to the command of God. That's how we are blessed. Number two is we follow. We follow what? God's will for us. I know the thought that I think towards you. Thought of good and not evil to bring you the expected end. Amen? That's God's will for you. Hebrews 10:7. He says, then said I, lo, I come. In the volume of the book it is written of me to do thy will. Oh God. Hebrews 10 verse 7. So number one, what is number one? Obedience to God's command. Number two, following God's will for him. That's why he was blessed. That's how you are going to be blessed. You have to follow the will of God for you. Number three, here is the double blessing. Amen. I said, here is the double blessing. Amen. Genesis 26 verse 5. I call it prior obedience and faithfulness of Abraham. Prior obedience and faithfulness of Abraham. Look at verse 5 in that Genesis 26, verse 5. Look at what God said concerning it. He says, because that Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge and my commandment, my statutes and my law. God says, the reason why I will do that, I will six times. It's not just because of your own obedience, which is wonderful, perfect, but as I think about your predecessor, your father, I now see that you are following the line of the blessing that I've earmarked for him. And so, the blessing that I said concerning him remains. But now, you are accumulating new blessings. So, double blessing then. I said double blessing then. So, prior obedience and faithfulness of Abraham. Galatians chapter 3 verse 9. Galatians 3 verse 9. So then, they which be of faith are blessed with faithful Abraham. Praise God. Well, how does that translate to you tonight? Your obedience, your faithfulness to God, what God has promised Abraham. Abraham's blessings are mine. Because Abraham was faithful and God blessed him. Everyone that becomes faithful in their generation, they inherit what God blessed Abraham with. So tonight, in your faithfulness, be blessed. In your obedience, be blessed. In following the will of God, be blessed. And that blessing will be multiplied upon you and your generation in Jesus' name. Now, why did God bless him? Let's read Genesis 26, verse 12. And why is God going to bless you? Then Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year 100-fold. And the Lord did what? Blessed him. The Lord did what? Blessed him. Now, you know, the man that God will bless is not an idle man. Praise God. There are many people who think, you know, God just blesses. Let's just sit down and wait for God's blessing. God doesn't act that way. God is not a waster. Tell somebody, God is not a waster. He wants to bless you, but when you look at the life of the people he blessed, they are not idle people. They are people who are willing to do something. They want to use their hand. Paul Apostle, even he said, we were not chargeable unto you. We did something. We made sure we produce something. Yes, you may meet us halfway. You may take care of, you know, he talked of Aquila and Priscilla, those who took care of him. Help us in the Lord. They did this, they did that. The home of people he stayed. But yet, even with all of that, with all the help and the blessing from others, he still walked. He was making tents. He was hardworking. He was not hiding. He was not an apostle that was just, you know, busybody going to everybody's house. What do you have to eat? What is available? Where are we now? You know, and then he's just laying down on their couch and, you know, it's like he owns the place. No, that's not the life of an apostle. You know, the average time that God gives to you, you go and you use it to do something. Even while you are serving the people of God, you are not idle. Amen. You're not idle. You don't, because the problem is that if you are idle and you can't provide for yourself, you know, even as a minister, then you become a reproach even to the church. You become a reproach. Because at the end of the day, you know, everyone who can offer this, if you start looking at their hand, looking at their every time, then you become like their puppet. You know, go here, go there. You know, we'll talk to him. We know how to talk to him. We know how to talk to him because if we just give him a couple of dollars, then we come back and say, this is what we want to do. And he can't say no. So you see, Isaac was, so write it down, Isaac's diligence and hard work coupled with God's blessing. So he partnered with God, so telling us that partnering with God yield great dividends. So if you want to write it down, let me start again. Isaac's diligence and hard work coupled with God's blessing shows us that partnering with God yield great dividend. Amen. You do your part, God will do his part. Don't allow God to finish doing his part and there's nowhere to put it. You know, God says, go and borrow vessels, not a few, right? Then you didn't borrow any. Then the oil comes. Are you going to pour it on the ground? You have to pour it into something. When the blessing of God comes, it has to reside in something. In a prepared vessel, you will be prepared. Amen. So the man was hardworking. He sowed. And he was expecting the Lord to bless him. Amen. Amen. 2 Peter 1:10. 2 Peter 1:10. Write it down. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, hard work, diligence, ye shall never fall. I say ye shall never fall. Hebrews 6:11, you can write that down. And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope unto the end. Be diligent in what you are doing. How did he get blessed? And how are you going to get blessed? Genesis 26. Look at verse 14 again. Genesis 26 and verse 14. For he had possessions of flocks, possessions of herds, and great store of servants. And the Philistine did what? And the Philistines did what? So there, when God blesses people, he has a reason. God wants to make you the envy of your neighbors. Praise God. Anybody who tells you that believers should not be blessed don't know what they are saying. Yes, we are not going to be so rich to the point that we forget God. That's not what God, but you will not lack any good thing. Amen. You know, the Bible says the Lord is a son and is a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory, and nothing good will take from them that do what? That walk up. You will not lack. He said the young lion do lack, but they that wait upon the Lord shall not lack any good thing. You can't lack. God doesn't want you to lack. God doesn't want you to become a laughing stock. He wants you to become the envy. Amen. In fact, in the book of is it Zechariah or so, he says, these are they that are wondered at. People see you, they are wondering, wow, what kind of Christianity is it? I mean, he's so buoyant, not just financially, but even in the spirit. Your spirit is buoyant, you are happy, you are joyful. Brethren, Christianity that makes people morose and gloomy, I'm not really sure of that. I'm telling you the truth. That doesn't mean that you are laughing, you know, uncontrollably. You are a jester. No, that's not. Christianity is, that's the other extreme. We are not jesting. We are not unserious. We are sober, but we are joyful. Amen. We are joyful. We are joyful people. Rejoice in the Lord. Again, I say, rejoice. So there is joy, but also you are watchful. So the joy is matched with watchfulness, with seriousness, with soberness. But then you are also joyful in the Lord. So Genesis 26 there verse 14 is for God's glory among envious nations. For God's glory. God wants to make you an envy, and that's what you will become. Amen. The envy of others. Psalm 63 verse 11. But the king shall rejoice in God. Everyone that sweareth by him, that is by God, shall glory. But the mouth of them that speak lies shall be stopped. That's what God wants. So that when you are rejoicing in God in the enlargement that he gave to you, if anybody is around that is feeling bad, well, he's just feeling bad because he can't touch anything. I said he can't touch what God is giving you. And nobody is going to touch your blessing. Amen. Your blessing will continue to increase in Jesus' name. Amen. He wants you to be the envy of the nations around you. Psalm 57 verse 5. 57 verse 5. Be thou exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let thy glory be above all they are. They want to see the people must see the glory of God upon your life. They must know that you are a blessed of the Lord. You know, you are a blessed of the Lord. God wants you to be so blessed spiritually, you are also physically, materially blessed, so that you can give to the work of God, you can give to the people of God, you can give, you have enough to take care of yourself and take care of the things of God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, next, why was Isaac blessed? And we are going to be blessed. I said you will be blessed. Yeah. Verse 17. And Isaac departed thence and pitched his tent in the valley of Gibeah and dwelt there. He did what? He departed. When the people started envying him, he didn't start saying, oh, what are you envying me for? And then start kind of trying to compromise so that they would love him. He separated himself from them. He wouldn't want them to contaminate his blessing. Because when God blesses you, if care is not taken, the envious people around, they may begin to do things that if your spirit is not strong, you begin to think, okay, maybe I need to do one thing to please them. You don't need to please any man. Just please God. I said, just please God. The moment you please God, all is well. I said, all is well. So we see here Isaac's separation from these heathen nations. The nations he was living with, they became envious, and he separated himself from them. God wants us to be separated from those who are there. You look at what Hebrews 7:26 says. Hebrews 7:26. For such an high priest became us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, yet separate from sinners and made higher than the heavens. Amen. Holy, harmless. You know, that doesn't mean that you want to separate from them, then you abuse them, you call them name. That's not a Christian way of behaving. You know, because if you abuse them, they abuse you back, there's no difference. You are just like them. You know, call them name and all of that. No, if you know that their ways are not, they're not going to promote you, just separate from them. And you don't have to look down on them. You don't have to call them name. Just separate yourself. So that when you separate yourself, if they want to follow your way of life, it is they who will be coming to you, not you going to them. Because all that you need, God has supplied. And everything you need, God will continue to supply. So we see Isaac's separation from these heathen nations. 2 Corinthians 6:17. 2 Corinthians 6:17. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, says the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. That's the word of God. God will receive you. Amen. Separate yourself. When you see people, it may even be religious people. I'm not just talking about sinners outside. It may even be people who say they come to church. We are church people. We are also okay. You know, I remember during the week I was somewhere over there and somebody said, I was listening to Bible, you know, reading a message on my phone where I was eating. I was having lunch and I was listening to the message. And the person looked and said, so what are you listening to there? Oh, I said, the word of God. Oh, he said, really? I said, yes. He said, do you believe in God? I said, absolutely. I said, do you believe too? He said, yeah. Are you born again? Yes. Are your sins forgiven? He said, oh, yeah. But, you know, even though I still have little sins here and there, but, you know, I've been saved and everything is all cleared up. I said, who told you that? So I referred her to 1 Peter 3. She read it. She said, my pastor told me, you know, when they meet you and they read those things to you, don't listen to them. I said, somebody wants you to get to hell. You know, by telling you don't listen. He said, my pastor said. I said, your pastor said. The Bible says, whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. And you say, sin is okay? He said, no, I'm not going to take that. Because, in fact, let me read another passage. I said, don't worry. Don't read another passage. I know what I'm doing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So I give that example to say that people may even be around. They say, we too, we are Christians. What is so special about you? Why are you like this? Why? You say, well, I'm a special Christian. A special Christian who obeys the command of the Lord. A special Christian, you know, who goes by the will of God. A special Christian who only accepts the blessing of God, who's not looking for blessing from any other man. A special Christian who's looking to God only. A special Christian who's an envy of others. People must envy you. Your light must shine that others will see it and they say, whatever is happening, that man, that woman, that boy, that girl, I want to have it. I pray it will be so with you. Yeah. I say it shall be so with you. So you separate yourself. And then Genesis 26 verse 22. We are very close to praying. Actually, I've done more preaching than I wanted to do today, but it's all okay. Amen. I believe you are getting something. And he removed from verse 22. 26, Genesis, verse 22. And he removed from thence and digged another well. And for that they strove not. And he called the name of it Rehoboth. And he said, for now. Everybody say now. For now. Now the Lord will enlarge you. Now the Lord will make room for you. Now the Lord will elevate you. Now the Lord will promote you. Now the Lord will do good in your life. Now your prayers are answered. For now, that's currently, right now, the Lord has made room for us. And we shall be fruitful in the land. You will be fruitful. Amen. That's Isaac's perseverance that you see there. People are striving with him. Brethren, don't give up so soon. Your fruitfulness is just around the corner. Amen. You know, your declaration, your showing, your exhibition, your excellence is just around the corner and people will see it. You know, they strove with him. But, you know, if it was like any of some people today, they would have given up very quickly. They say, I'm tired of all this striving and all of that. Life is about striving. Bible says we wrestle. We are fighting. It's a daily thing, every day. You say you are a believer, you are not fighting, then what are you doing every day? You, from the moment you wake up in the morning till night, you are fighting. Every moment of your life. You are fighting the devil, you are fighting sin, you are fighting temptation. Oh, is there anybody who is no longer being tempted here? Anybody? No longer tempted. Everything is just free. The devil don't bother you anymore. Then I wonder if you actually have anything. Because if you have something of substance, the devil wants to get it. Your salvation is great substance. Your inheritance in heaven is great substance. The promises of God in your life, great substance. The peace in your family, the devil wants to fight it. The devil will love that we are hearing that husband and wife that you are fighting every day. And some, you know, the neighbors are coming and say, "Where? What is going on with these people? Let's call the police on them." Satan will like that. But praise God, that's not happening in your home. Praise God, it will never happen in your home. Devil is fight is everyday battle. You are battling over your children, you are battling over your family, you are battling even to continue to serve God every day. It's a battle. The devil is telling you, why do you keep going? Why do you keep going? Look at this prayer. Look at this. Look at that. He's pointing things to you. But you are not going to see those things. Amen. You will not give time for those things. Amen. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. So we see Isaac's perseverance here. He persevered until he prevailed. You will persevere and prevail. Amen. You will persevere and prevail. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the spirit, and washing thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. That's Ephesians 6:18. Now 2 Timothy 2:3. Thou therefore endure hardness. Amen. Endure hardness. Life is not always going to give it to you easily. If you're having it easy now, it's because of the fight you fought before. But don't think the devil has given up on that fight. Even what you have gained from him, he still wants to steal. He wants to take them back, but he will not succeed. Amen. I said he will not succeed. So continue to persevere. Endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. You know, I've watched some military expedition, and you see some soldier how, you know, it's like there's no life left in them, but they say, we have to keep going. And you are wondering, where did they get that from? Well, it's part of their training. They've been trained to say, no pain. No pain. You know, I remember a particular boxer used to say that. No pain. No pain. I don't care how what you hit him with, no pain. And so, he defeated so many people because when you thought you capture him and put him in a corner and you are kicking him, he's saying, no pain, no pain. And he's not feeling anything. You are just, it's like you are throwing air on him. And when he gets out of that corner and hits you with the brutish nature that he has, you fall down. So people just fall down for him all the time. No pain. When the devil is hitting you, tell him no pain. I said no pain. Don't let the devil keep hitting you and then you are like a jelly. Oh, look at all, he's hitting me. You think that's how nobody succeeds that way? He's hitting me here. Look at it. The devil just made somebody to abuse me here. And then that one called me name. And look at what that's. And all those things that is striking you. You know, you want to become a jelly. You will not be a jelly. Yeah. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his mind. God will keep you strong. Yeah. I said, God will keep you strong. Yeah. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the strength of the Lord will never depart from you. In the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 4:5. We read 2:3, but let's read 4:5. But wash thou in all things. Amen? Amen. Wash thou in all things. Endure afflictions. Do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. Endure. Be a man that endure. Don't give in to the lies of the devil. Now, finally, Genesis 26:24-25. This is very important. I've talked about it, but we still need to emphasize it as one of the points. Genesis 26 is an extra. I've given you 7 points already, but this is like an extra, right? It's an extra thing you need to look at. Have I given you 7 things? I think so. Is it 6? Okay, number 1 is what? Obedience to God's command. Number 2 is following God's will. Number 3 is prior obedience and faithfulness of Abraham. Number 4 is Isaac's diligence and hard work coupled with God's blessing. Number 5 is God's glory among envious nations, right? Number 6 is Isaac's separation from the heathen, the heathen nations. Number seven is Isaac's perseverance. So I was counting. Praise God. I know where I was. I was counting. Praise God. All right. So the last one, the extra that I want to give you, which is very important. I've said it, but I want to read it for you. Genesis 26, verse 24. 26, 24. Here, and the Lord appeared unto him the same night and said, I am the God of Abraham, thy father. Fear not, for I am with thee and will bless thee and multiply thy seed for my servant Abraham's sake. Amen. Well, look at verse 25 now. That's what God said. Well, look at what he did in response. And he builded an altar there and called upon the name of the Lord and pitched his tent there. And there Isaac's servants digged a well. Continual relationship with God. Amen. It's not a one-time thing. So you can write down Isaac's continual relationship with God despite the blessings. Amen. When people get blessed, they think that's it. No, it's just the beginning. More are coming.
Amen.
And your continual relationship with God will be the doorway for more blessings.
Amen.
So don't get the blessing and run with it. I need a child. Children are here. What do I need God for? I run. I'm sorry. Don't do like that. Because you can't keep those children. There is a devil that is running after them. I've got a good job and now... See, let me go and settle with that job and make sure everything is okay. Who gave you the job? If you get the job and you go and sleep at that job, God will take it. The devil will take it anyway, not God. Because you need God to keep it, but if you run away from God, then God is no longer with you, then the devil is watching for the slightest opportunity to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He will not accomplish it in your life.
Amen.
Isaac's continual relation with God despite the blessings. Acts 26, verse 22. Acts 26, 22. Having therefore obtained help of God, I continue unto this day. What did you do?
I
said, what will you do? With the blessing God will give you tonight, what will you do? With the more blessings that are still coming later, what will you do? Continue. And the blessing will continue.
Amen.
I said the blessing will continue. Romans 11, 22. Romans 11, 22. Behold therefore the goodness and severity of God. On them which fell, severity. But towards thee, I say towards thee, I say towards thee, say towards me, towards me, goodness, if thou continue in his goodness. You see that? Severity to others who don't continue, but goodness towards you, because you will continue. Are you going to continue? I said, are you going to continue? Rise up and let's talk to the Lord. Rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up. We are going to continue. Why was Isaac blessed? All those things I read to you, that's the reason why you are going to be blessed. And so tonight, the Lord who enlarged and made room, the room maker, the maker of the heavens and earth, your own maker, who enlarged Isaac, who enlarged Abraham, that God is still present here. That God is available tonight. Open your mouth and just bless him. Make your commitment to him and say, Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. I bless you. I glorify you. I magnify you. I exalt you, Lord. Thank you tonight. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. You are the God of blessing. Just exalt him. Just magnify him. Whatever comes to your mouth in terms of just praising God, go ahead. Go ahead. The names of God that is in your mouth, go ahead. Go ahead. You know, in your language, in whatever way, just go ahead and praise him. And praise him. And praise him. Exalt the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. Father, we glorify you. We exalt you. We magnify you for who you are. Thank you, Lord. You are a God of blessing. You are the God that establishes. You are the God, oh Lord, that formed the maker. You formed me. You made me for a purpose, for a plan. You said you will, you will, you will. And I know that your will shall be done in my life. Thank you, Lord, tonight. Thank you for your word. Thank you for what you did in Abraham. Thank you for what you did in Isaac. Even up to Jacob and to Joseph, oh Lord, and the generations, oh Lord, Father, that came after. Thank you, oh Lord, Father, for the faithfulness of your word. Thank you, because whatever you say, you will do. You are the one who can say and do. You are the one who will do what you say. We bless you. We glorify you for all that your purpose and plan. You are the one that enlarges. You are the one that enlarges. Lord, we come to you tonight for enlargement. Oh, God of glory. Father, visit us. Greet us tonight. Father, for enlargement. We want to first thank you for all that you have done. Thank you for all that you have done in our family, in our life. Thank you for all that you have done. What you have given, what you have provided. Thank you for all that you have done. We are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful. We bless you, Jehovah God. We magnify you, Jehovah God. We exalt you, Jehovah God. We glorify you, Jehovah God. Be thou exalted. Be thou exalted. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty Father. Glory be unto your name. Glory be unto your name. Glory be unto your name. Blessed be thy holy name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Blessed be thy holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. I gave you the will of God in that Genesis 26 that we read. He says, I will bless thee. I will be with thee. I will bless thee. I will give thee. I will perform. I will make thy seed. I will give unto thy seed. That's the God that makes and performs. We are going to ask God tonight that all that needs to be made and all that needs to be performed in your life, in my life, that God will begin that process now. God will begin that process now. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, all that needs to be made, what has been unmade by the enemy, what has been unmade by my own mistake and ignorance, what has been unmade in my life, what has gone wrong in a way that, oh Lord, Father, things are not wrong anywhere, but now, Lord, I bring me, myself, everything, totality of me, everything, no exception. I bring it to you, to your throne, oh Lord, to your workshop. Father, I am in your workshop tonight. I am in your workshop, in the heavenly workshop, in the divine workshop. Father, everything that needs to be made, everything that needs to be done, everything that needs to be completed concerning me, concerning my life, concerning my ministry, concerning my family, oh Lord, my character, my behavior, my living, oh Lord, Father, everything that I do, Father. I pray, I ask, oh Lord, in my knowledge, everything that needs to be made, Holy Spirit divine, visit me, oh God, Father. Reach me, oh Lord, Father, tonight in a deep way. Anything that needs to do, maybe there is a surgery that is needed. Father, reach unto me, even to the depth of my heart, to the depth of my soul, to the depth of my spirit. Father, reach me tonight. Everything that still needs to be done, whatever, oh Lord, is half done, whatever is halfway done, oh God of glory, I pray. Finish the job. Finish your job. Finish your work in me. Where I've been in hurry and I've gone too far ahead of you, Father, slow me down now so that I can come to a place where your work is completed. Your work is completed. Father, in the name of Jesus, help me, Father. Help me, Father. Help me, Father. Help me, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Many a times as human beings, we think and then we want to run ahead of God. That's what was about to happen to Isaac here. You know the story of Isaac. You know, with all his faithfulness, with all the knowledge of God, but he was thinking. You know, he never said that he was going to Egypt, but the God that knows the heart of man knows his heart. He was planning to go to Egypt, and God stopped him. God cut him short because he was going to a place where his blessing will be lost. And God says, no, you cannot go to where your blessing will be lost. Open your mouth and tell God, Father, anything I want to do now that will hinder, oh Lord, the fullness of your blessing, stop me right there. Oh Lord, stop me right there. Oh Lord, put me on the right path. Put me on the right path. Oh Lord, Father, silence, oh Lord, Father, every action, every thought in my heart that is contrary to your will. Any thought that does not align with you. Maybe I'm thinking about something. I'm thinking about, I want to do this, I want to do this, and God is saying, no, that's not according to my will. Oh Lord, I pray tonight by your spirit, by your power, Lord of glory, in the mighty name of Jesus, help me tonight. Oh Lord, stop it so that action will not proceed in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. What do you think will have happened to Isaac if he had gone down to Egypt? He would have lost the presence of God. He would have lost the blessing of God. All that God promised here, he would not have been able to get it. But thank God for a man that will remain in the will of God. We are going to ask God and say, Father, give us a fresh relationship with you. Help us to have a fresh relationship, a renewed relationship. Father, help me, oh Lord, Father, to renew my relationship with you. Right now, Father, that I hear you every day, like Isaac. Isaac was a man that hears God, that listens to God, that God talks to him. He can hear God, he knows what God is saying. Oh God of glory, I pray, open my ears, open my ears, open my ears. Let my eyes be open. All those thoughts and imaginations that, oh Lord, the things of the world are controlling, are channeling. All the things that are channeling, oh Lord, things into me. Father, I pray, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, Father, oh Lord, every decision that has been conditioned by the situation around me, oh God, I pray, stop them right now. Stop them, oh Lord, Father. Open my ears, open my heart, open my mind, so that I can know what you want me to do. Father, direct me and lead me and guide me in the right path, oh Lord, Father, by your grace and power. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Spirit divine, we pray. We ask, oh God, Father, your spirit, your power, your grace be made available, oh Lord, as you did to Isaac. Oh Lord, make it available to us. Make it available to us. In the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, God of glory, we are asking and praying. Visit us individually. Visit our homes individually. In the name of Jesus, let your blessing and your favor, oh Lord, never depart from us. Oh Lord, stop us where we are about to make mistake. Where we are about to make mistake. Holy Spirit divine, where we are about to make mistake. I'm asking and praying. I'm asking and praying. Father, Father, hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray. I don't know why, you know, God is impressing it in my heart, and I'm trying to say, maybe not, maybe it's me, but he keeps repeating. You know, the Spirit of God keeps imparting it continually. Pray this prayer. Pray this prayer. You know, because there's somebody within your midst who is about to make a big mistake, who is about to take some decisions. You know, that's going to destroy things he has been building, or she has been building for quite a while. He's going to make a mistake. He's going to take a decision that is rash, that is not the will of God. So let us pray. Father, you Lord, Father, for every one of us here tonight, or for every member of our church, no decision will be made, oh Lord, Father, that will destroy eternal life, that will destroy eternal habitation, that will destroy our relationship with God, that will destroy the blessing. Any decision, any place we want to do, anything we want to do, Father, that will take your blessing away from us, oh God, we pray and ask, oh Lord, those things will not be done. Father, you will not allow us to take those decisions. We will not be able to do those things, oh Lord. You will hinder us, oh Lord, in that path, oh Lord, that path of destruction, that path that is not godly, that path that is contrary to the will of God. Father, oh Lord, put a stop to it and make our ears to be open tonight. In the name of Jesus, turn off away from the path of destruction. Anything that will hinder us, hinder our family, hinder our children, hinder our posterity, our generation to come. Father, I pray, assist us so that we will not take that decision. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. There is a word of God here, even though it's negative, but it's not for you, it's for the enemy. Amen. He says, therefore, in Hosea chapter 2, verse 6, therefore, behold, I will hedge up thy way with thorns, and make a wall, that she shall not find a path. God will edge in the enemies of your soul. God says, I will edge you, you will not find the path. Brethren, you will not find that wrong path where you are going to go into, and it's going to destroy everything you have ever done. Brethren, there are people who make just one decision and their Christian life is over. Think about all that Judas, you know, all his exercise with Jesus for 3.5 years. One decision, and he was a forgotten man forever. One decision. You know, that's it. Samson, he followed that one path, and that was it. Achan, he never find a place to repent. Oh, you said that's Old Testament, Pastor. What of Ananias and Sapphira? You know, just one little decision of, let's just, you know. But it was your own. It doesn't matter. This is what we are going to do. Nobody knew. God know now. God know. The decisions you will make that will rob you of the blessing of God. Look at how the church in the Acts was blessed. These people missed the blessing. They were taken out unexpectedly. They were taken out in the flower of their age. We are going to ask God, Father, any decision I will take, oh Lord, that will rob me of the blessing of God, that will rob me of the presence of God, that will rob me of my relationship with God. Father, let that decision stop right now In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray and say, Father, any place I will go, anything I will do that will rob me of your blessing, that will rob me of your presence, that will rob me of your abiding grace. Oh Lord, I pray right now, let it be stopped in the name of Jesus. Let it not progress. Let it not move forward. God of glory, I'm asking and praying by your spirit and power. Lord, you are going to help me. You are going to help me. You will help your people tonight. Lord, to possess the best, oh Lord, Father, that you have for us. And any decision that we are going to make, oh Lord, that will rob us of our blessing. Oh God of glory, I pray. I pray. You will take it away, oh God. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Isaiah 49, verse 11. 49, 11. And I will make all my mountains a way, and my highways shall be exalted. Every highway, every mountain, God mighty will remove them out of the way. God will make a way. Say, I will make all my mountains a way. Whatever mountain is before you, God will make a way. I said, God will make a way. That anything that looks like a mountain and difficult before you, say, Lord, make a way. Lord, make it. It can make a way where there seems to be no way. That's the God of enlargement. Open your mouth and say, Father, tonight, enlarge me. Enlarge my course. Enlarge, oh Lord, Father, the place of my residence. Enlarge me in my profession. Enlarge me spiritually. Enlarge my career. Enlarge me in my family. Enlarge me in every area. Enlarge me in my health. Let my health capacity increase. Oh Lord, any unhealthy feeling, unhealthy situation, Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, you will shoot it down, you will cast it down, so that Lord, you will enlarge my health. I'll become healthy. I'll be whole again. Every part of me will be healthy. Oh Lord, the Bible says I will give them health and cure. Health and cure. Ask God and say, Father, oh Lord, that covenant of health and cure, I possess it tonight. The covenant of health and cure, I possess it for myself. I possess it for my children. I possess it for my wife. I possess it for my family. I possess it for the church of God, for the people of God, every man, every woman, in the name of Jesus. We possess the covenant of health. We possess the covenant of cure of every disease, of every situation, in the name of Jesus. Father, let it be so. Father, let it be so. You are the one that enlarges. Father, enlarge us. Enlarge us by your grace. Enlarge us by your power. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Blessed be thy holy name. Blessed be thy holy name. In the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord, that the Lord will do it. That the Lord will do it. God will enlarge you. God will enlarge you. God will increase you. Everything that you need for enlargement and increase, the Lord of glory will do it. He will do it. He will do it. He will do it. To his glory, praise, and honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. He is the God of enlargement. Tell him tonight, Father, enlarge me, enlarge me, enlarge me. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. How will God enlarge you? Maybe that's a question we can ask. Proverbs 18:16 says, a man's gift make room for him, and it bring him before great men. A man's gift. So you are going to tell the Lord, Father, all the giftedness you are giving unto me, let it bring enlargement to me. Every giftedness you are giving unto me, Father, let it begin to bring me enlargement. Let my gift never be forgotten. Oh Lord, let my gift never be forgotten. Everywhere I find myself, either in the spiritual or in the secular, let my gift bring enlargement. Let my gift never, oh Lord, Father, never be forgotten, never be forgotten. In the name of Jesus, let it never be forgotten. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, I know some of us may say, I don't even know if I have a gift. Let me tell you of a man. All he had was the gift of telling the truth and being steadfast. Do you know his name? Mordecai. Praise God. You never think about that. But it was a gift. Being a Jew, This is the giftedness God gave him. He will be a steadfast man, an uncompromising man, a man that is true to the things of God, and that will enlarge him. You know, even when he told the truth so that the king was not killed, it looked like they forgot it. But the Bible says a man's gift does what? Let me read it to you again. Proverbs 18:16. A man's gift maketh room for him. There was no room for a gatekeeper to become second in command. There was no room in that place, but God made a room. Tell the Lord tonight, where there is no room, Father, make a room for me. Like God that made a room for Mordecai, make a room for me. In the name of you, open your mouth and pray. And say, Father, even where there seems to be no room, but you are the one that find a place. You find a place for Mordecai. You find a man who was just a gate man, a gate man. He doesn't have any earthly gift, any secular gift, but he has spiritual gift. He was consistent. He was a lover of God. He was a steadfast man. He was a faithful man. That was his own gift. He was not a compromiser. That gift made the way for him. Open your mouth and say, Father, where I am walking and in the church of God and in my family, Father, all the giftedness of God for me, all the spiritual in the inspiration that you're giving me by your word, by your grace, let them make a way for me. Make a way for me, oh God, Father. Let it do it for me in the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord that God will make a way. He will make a way. He's make a way. He will make a way for you in the name of Jesus. He will make a way for you by his spirit and by his power. Lord of glory, enlarge me. You are the God of enlargement. The one who makes. Enlarge me, O God. Enlarge my coast. Enlarge my tent. Enlarge the place of my dwelling. In the name of Jesus. Give me enlargement, my Father. Give me enlargement, my God. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Isaiah 17 verse 7. At that day shall a man look to his maker, and his eyes shall have respect to the Holy One of Israel. Do you know that's a gift? Praise God. That you look at God and you have respect to him. You say, that's my maker. That's my God. You don't know that in itself. There are people who say there is no God. Bible says, the fool has said in his heart. Aha. So, your gifting, don't look for a gift. I can do this. No, that's not what I'm saying. There are gifts that God has given unto you. Your salvation is a gift. Let your salvation make a way for you. Let your sanctification make a way for you. Let your consistency in the things of God make a way for you. Let the holiness of God make a way from you. Don't look for something too far. A man shall look unto his maker and he says, you are my God. And for that only, God will make a way from him. God will make a way. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, you are my maker. You are my God. You are all that I look unto. You are the Holy One of God. You are the one that I respect. Father in heaven, make a way for me in the way that only you can do it. Only you. Anything man cannot do. Anything man cannot do. That's what I'm bringing to you. Not what man can do, but what you only can do. Make a way for me. Tell the Lord and say, where the door has been closed against me, where there have been conspiracy against me, like Mordecai. You know, there was a conspiracy of Haman saying we are going to kill him and his people, but the Lord made a way. Let's tell God, Father, for us as a church, for Deeper Christian Life Ministry in America, make a way for us. For the doctrine of the Word of God, make a way for us. For this church to preach more of holiness and to be accepted, make a way for us. Make a way. We look like, you know, nobody's accepting right now, but let the Word of God make a way for us. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. You know, when Pastor Kumuyi, again, he happened to be our earthly example, so pardon us if we always refer to him. You know, when he started the church, some people came to him. They said, you think people are going to listen to you? All this, your holiness, 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 be righteous, be holy. Who is going to? Say, nobody. Say, nobody in this country will listen to you. A man's gift make a way for him. He brings him before kings. The man that they said, nobody's going to, the message that say, nobody's going to listen to. Eh? Are those people right now? I said, were those people right? No, they're not right. Because what they said is not going to work. You know what? Pardon me to say this. Even where he himself came out, God has enlarged him more than where he came out. Sincerely. Where they mock him and they said, you know, the word of God, brethren, sometimes we say, hey, all we have is just the word of God. Listen, brethren, what does Billy Graham preach? Does he do healing? I've never heard anybody say, I went to Billy Graham program and I got healed. Does that mean that God is still not there? He preached the word of God. Millions get saved. Amen. God, by his word, by just the simplicity of the word of God in his mouth, God was glorified and God enlarged him. Father, Lord, just by the word of God that we have as a church, enlarge our coast. Use this word of God that you are giving to deeper life. Use it to enlarge us in America. Open your mouth and pray. Say, Father, let the word of God enlarge our coast here. So that, Father, one way or the other, you will make a way for us. Make a way that the mountains, oh Lord, you will make a way through our mountain. In the name of Jesus, you will enlarge us. You will enlarge us. That, oh Lord, Father, as we look unto you, oh God, Father, as our maker, my God and my Lord, you will make a way for us. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. We look unto you, God of heaven. Make a way, make a way, make a way, make a way. In the name of Jesus, let there be a way for us. Let there be a way for your church. Let there be a way for your people. In the mighty name of, you are our maker. Lord, you are our maker. Yes, yes, make a way for us. Make a way for us. Make a way for us. In the name of Jesus, by your grace and power. By your grace and power, make a way for us, O God. Make a way for us, O God. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Jeremiah 35. I'm just going to tell you what makes a way. Jeremiah 35 verse 10. But we have dwelt in tents and have obeyed and done according to all that Jonadab, our father, commanded us. Did you see that? You say, hey, what's the gift? What's your gift? Just being steadfast. We are just steadfast people. Whatever we are told, we do. We don't say civilization has come. Whatever we are told is no longer good. You know? Whatever you've been taught. Everything I've been written at four times. I've written for what? For our learning. You know, you don't say, oh, look at civilization. Hey, look at it. You see, these days I hear even people preaching in this land of those things we used to cherish in those days. I pray that God will bring us to it. Amen. You know, those things that we know that in those, that was what made this church tick. And now because maybe we are in America or we are getting civilized, those words are beginning to look like, what is it? No. When you preach it right and you stand by it, God will stand with you. I said, God will stand with you. When you are faithful to God, even in little things, God will be faithful with you. He says, we have stood by the word of our Father. What he told us to do, he said, we have dwelt, but we have dwelt in tents. No, think about that. Their father told them they should dwell in tents. When the people were building houses around them, they said, that our father didn't tell us to live in houses. I can see people coming and say, oh, look at these people. Look at good houses are being built and they want to dwell in tents. They want to dwell in tents. But they said, that's what our father told us. Amen? Yes. There is a blessing that comes from an Abraham to an Isaac. Amen? The reason Isaac was greatly blessed was because he was following in the blessing of his father. Can we pray and say, Father, let the blessing of our father follow us. Our father of faith, let the blessing of God upon him, Father, be multiplied upon every one of us. As we obey you, as we follow the word of God, as we are taught. Because we are not taught anything wrong. It's just that we are trying to modernize ourselves. You know, we can't live in tent anymore. We should live in good houses. We should do this, we should do that. Well, the Lord is saying, is that what you are taught? Is that what you are taught, that you are becoming modernized? Everything must be but Lord, help us. You know, look at what God said to the Rechabite. In verse 18, and Jeremiah said unto the house of Rechabah, thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, because ye have obeyed the commandment of Jonadab your father, and kept all his precepts, and done according unto all he has commanded you. Therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Jonadab the son of Rechab shall not want a man to stand before me forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I pray obedience will make a way for you. I said obedience will make a way for you. Open your mouth and say, Father, help me to be so obedient that your obedience to you will make a way for me. I'll be obedient in all things, in all things, in everything. Oh Lord, help me, assist me. Make me obedient. Make a way, make a way, make a way. In the name of Jesus, in my job, let obedience make a way. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, oh Lord, we bless you. Oh Lord, we glorify you. We magnify you. We exalt you. We magnify magnify you for all that you have done. Begin to praise God now. Begin to praise God. Because tonight he is the God that enlarges. He says, I am the Lord thy God in Psalm 81 verse 10, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Open thy mouth wide and I will fill it. Open your mouth wide tonight and tell God, in whatever area as we are rounding up, what area specifically do you want God to enlarge you? What area do you need enlargement? You know, I'm going to give you about 5 minutes to pray that prayer for yourself, and then we are going to round up. Begin to pray for yourself now. Bless the Lord. Begin to bless the Lord. Bless the Lord tonight. Bless him. We are moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Deeper life is moving forward. Hallelujah. I believe I have more people here tonight. Children, rise up and sing. The church is moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. My family is moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Your family is moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Our women are moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Our youths are moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. All the children are moving forward. Hallelujah. Oh yes, amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Everybody is moving forward. You need to sing that for yourself. Don't be quiet. I want to hear those who are moving forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. I decree in the name of Jesus that you begin to move forward.
Amen.
Every stagnancy, we put an end to it. We command by the name that is above all names, the name of Jesus, that every shackles in your life be broken. Every road that is closed, we command the bulldozer of heaven to make a way through them in Jesus' name. We pray for supernatural bridges from heaven to supernaturally appear upon every sea that has cut you off from your blessing in Jesus' name. All those who are sitting on your folder, let the fire of God get them up in Jesus' name. Let the seed be hot for them. I say, let their seed be hot for them. Father, reveal the abundance of blessing that you have for your people and take the enemy away from their possession in Jesus' name. Amen. Let this church move forward. Amen. Let the brothers move forward. Amen. Let the sisters move forward. Amen. Lord, we decree those who may be sick right now, we command, move out of your sickness in Jesus' name. Amen. And as you come out into the health, into the cure that the blood of Jesus has procured for you in Jesus' name. Those who don't have job or who are lacking one area or the other, enter into the abundance of God. Enter into the surplus of heaven. In the name of Jesus, those whose spiritual lives are dry, Lord, I ask right now the windows of heaven to open upon them. The joy of heaven to come into their soul. The Spirit of God and the showers of heaven to drench them right now in Jesus' name. Father, we command a refreshing from heaven. We command newness from heaven. We command power from heaven. We command strength from heaven. We command grace from heaven. Oh Lord, pour it upon your church in Jesus' name. Those that the enemy has buffeted, take all the buffeting away. Renew their heart. Renew their spirit. Renew their zeal. Those who have loved you in time past and they seem to be cold now, Father, let the fire of the love of God fall upon them in Jesus' name. Make us passionate. Make us zealous. Set us on fire for your glory in Jesus' name. Isaac obeyed you and he was blessed. But I pray the spirit of obedience bestow it upon every man. Amen. Isaac followed your will. I pray, Father, let all our will be bent and destroyed so that the will of God will come into our lives in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for all your obedient children. Let them enter into the blessing of our fathers of faith that you have promised unto them, like Abraham, in Jesus' name. Father, make your people diligent. Make them diligent. Let them persevere. Oh Lord, make them envious of their neighbor in Jesus' name. The neighbors around them begin to envy them. The neighbors around them begin to wonder about them. Father, do something spectacular in every life here tonight in Jesus' name. As we go home, surprise us. Surprise us. Beyond our imagination, surprise us tonight in Jesus' name. Thank you for the answer. We bless and glorify you. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. So shall it be in Jesus' name.